Catching the Buzz, a young CEO on her lemonade business, which was inspired by bees. A little more than halfway through Be Fearless, the 10-year-old CEO, Michaela Omer, has her first encounter with a fancy advertising agency. Its experts love the mission of her lemonade business and wonder if they can help. She takes the meeting, and a designer lets her in on a secret. It's not the product you sell, but the story you tell. And so we get this rarest of book reads, the middle grade startup memoir by a teenager. Any CEO book ought to do two things. First, it should be a rip-roaring tale of how the author did it, warts and all. The origin story of Ulmer's company begins with bee stings, after which her parents encourage her to learn about the insects rather than fear them. The bees are in danger. It turns out, as is a large amount of our food supply, if conditions worsen, they no longer pollinate in masses. So the 4-year-old set up a lemonade stand outside of her house in Austin, Texas. She sweetens her lemonade with honey, since bees make it and it's healthy. She serves it with a side of education on things as a pain. The first batch of lemonade is awful, but a series of sticky experiments yields something better, unique even, after she gets the idea from her great-grandmother recipe to add flaxseed. Best of all, it's a product with a purpose, since she donates money to bee-regulated organizations. People around Austin notice. The owner of a pizza place offers to sell the beverage if she bottles it. Then, the head of the local Black Chamber of Commerce urges her to audition for the TV series Shark Tank. You can guess what happens next. If you don't already know, Ulmer gets on the show, goes to Hollywood, and one of the sharks bites. She leaves in town with a $60,000 investment, and by the end of the book, Me and the Bees Lemonade is in more than 1,500 stores. So we have our good yarn. The second task is harder for anyone, let alone a teenager, selling her story to other kids. How do you leave people believing that they too could pull something like this off? As with any child prodigy, readers will wonder about the stage parents. Ulmer doesn't sugarcoat. Both her parents have business degrees. Her father worked at Dell. Her mother owned a marketing firm. Eventually, her mom joins Me and the Bees full-time. A group of current and former NFL players invest $810,000 into the company. An increase to scale enables it to lower the shelf price to $2.99 per 12-ounce bottle. But we don't learn how much money Ulmer is taking out for herself or her college fund, nor do we learn how much has gone to the Bees. Private companies have no obligations to report such figures, but authors ought to give a little more up. Like many founders' stories, Ulmer's book is meant partly as self-help. Here she delivers. Bless her for stressing the importance of thank you notes. She also writes often and well about connecting with strangers over a brief transaction. Selling remains of one of the most underappreciated and undertaught life skills. Many grown-ups never learn the art of the pitch. Remembering names is crucial too. When Ulmer goes to the White House for the kids' state dinner, Michelle Obama sees her and says, "Oh, hi, Michaela. I know you. Come here." Before acknowledging her work, I noted it. Ulmer writes, "Make people feel special and comfortable." Near the book's end, Ulmer describes telling a book of girls in South Africa to imagine what it would feel like to buy things they want without having to ask others for help. Parents who recalled their own first childhood purchase probably remembers the tingle they felt that moment and want it for their own kids too.